Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. And welcome back to another Instagram versus reality. Today I want to talk about something. I usually talk about like the beauty and skincare side of retouching and Instagram versus reality, but one thing I think is also really, really important is just the reality of influencers' lives. Because most of the time it could be just as fake as their skin. One thing that's always baffled me as an influencer, and I actually find really embarrassing, is other influencers flashing their wealth, showing it off, kind of like rubbing it in the faces of their viewers, and then giving them that as content. I don't know. I get it if your whole thing is reviewing luxury products, or you're, you know, buying an expensive house and your whole thing is making it up, or you review cars. Is that a thing? I don't know. I get that if you're in the luxury side of things. But in a way, I've always seen subscribers as almost like my boss, I guess you can say, because ultimately, viewers and subscribers are the people who tells you what work, tells you what doesn't. Ultimately, they kind of control the direction of your content. Views equals interest. And I kind of find these like showing off of wealth videos almost tacky. It's like you going up to your boss with like a load of money in your hand and like throwing it on them, being like, you gave me this. I don't know. I find it really strange. But there is this really odd industry of influencers pretending to be wealthy in order to pretend they are successful, in hopes that people seeing how wealthy they are will actually get them a lot of views, a lot of subscribers, ultimately, eventually really living that wealthy lifestyle that they're pretending they have. You know, get what I mean? It's kind of like a circle. And yeah, you heard me right. It's a popular industry. There is a fake wealth industry for influencers and wannabe influencers in order to make themselves look like they are rich. I'm embarrassed talking about this. I find it so strange. And again, really tacky. I don't know. I don't know whether just because like I'm British and we kind of brought up not to talk about money and not to kind of like show off, and I don't know. So I want to share some of the services that are available to influencers to pretend they're rich. Some people don't even do that. They just fake it and Photoshop it. And I actually did a poll that I want you to take into consideration whilst we're talking about this video here on my community tab. I asked, do you find influencers showing off their wealth aspirational or out of touch? With only 6% saying it's aspirational and 94% saying it's out of touch. And that's from 21,000 votes. Some comments stand out to me is this one by Sasha Minium saying, I chose out of touch, but to add context, how often the person does it and the manner in which they do it makes a difference, at least to me. I agree with you. Sharing occasionally and because they are generally happy and excited about well-deserved success doesn't really bother me. Sharing constantly and as if you're bragging or trying to get a brand to pay attention to you gets old pretty quickly. And we will be talking about influencers pretending that they're working with luxury brands in a minute. But I completely agree with you. I think there's a difference between showing off your wealth that your platform gave you and being excited about buying your first designer bag or moving into a house with your partner, owning your first house. You know, I think there's people are genuinely happy for you until you start to kind of like rub it in people's faces. And that really does sum up, I would say, like more than 90% of people's opinions on this. So let's get into these services. One of the most popular services, locations you may say, and one that I think a lot of us has probably seen without even realizing, is the private jet. There is a studio in Los Angeles that have a very, I would say, overused set of a private jet. And for only $64 an hour, I say only, that's expensive. But you know, amongst 10 influencers, $64 for an hour is nothing to get a quick picture of you pretending to be on a private jet, going somewhere for some reason privately. I don't personally care if I see someone on a private jet, it doesn't mean anything to me. So I don't really get. I guess it's to give the impression that the influencer has somewhat of a celebrity status or is successful enough to have been invited onto a private jet. Much like the Kardashians have their own private jet and they kind of like fly around having somewhere important to be that they need to go separately. I don't know. I'll be honest, I don't get private jets. I don't know. Well, maybe I do. I don't know. Celebrity status equaling success, I guess you can say. So yeah, I find that a little bit odd. Like, would you pay $64 for a post of you appearing to be on a private jet? Do people care if you're on a private jet? I feel like it's a very old way of looking at... We'll talk about that in a minute. Anyway, a French influencer and reality TV star, Oceane Elheimer, I may have said that wrong, was flying from Dubai to Monaco, a 7-hour flight if you have no stops. She posted a picture of herself in business class with the caption, "Next stop, Monaco. I fly all night." There she is in business class. That's where you expect a reality TV star influencer of a certain degree to be, I guess. However, a fan of hers who just happened to be on the same flight of her actually spotted her in her seat in economy class. Her fan tweeted about this after seeing her post of her standing up in business class, and the tweet went pretty viral while she was on the flight, with the tweet loosely translating to, "Oceane, who is kind of traveling business class while traveling in eco, the worst part is that she took the time to take a picture of herself in business just to be that girl on Insta." With many people condemning for her for being a typical fake influencer and a terrible role model in some people's own words. But some were actually impressed by her like business brain and savviness, I guess you can say, with one person actually tweeting, "I actually applaud this. She posted what she knows will do well and ultimately get her paid, whilst also saving money by buying a cheaper seat as opposed to unnecessary luxury. Seems like why spending to me and the rest of y'all are weird for hating and caring so much." I would argue that the influencer is weird for caring so much that she might be seen in economy. Wouldn't you? I personally think it's very embarrassing. I would be mortified. You go on a plane, you are directed to your seat. You have the stewardesses at the front. They look at your ticket, they direct you where to go. So she would have had to make a very good effort. Actually, she could have been walking through business, but she would have had to make the effort to go into business, possibly stop people from getting to their seat, just to have a picture taken in business. She may have organized it with the flight, you know, who knows? Like, everyone would be seeing you do that. And also the idea of influencers being rich, and all successful influencers have to be rich to be successful, is very outdated to me. This kind of like timeline of influencer to celebrity, I don't think really exists anymore. There are so many influencers that are, there are just too many for everyone to make it to this kind of like celebrity status. You could be a very successful influencer on like 32,000 followers. I think a study kind of showed that most people, like 42,000 odd number, make a good basic wage, you know, livable wage, if not more. And you could be there your whole life. You know, the goal isn't always to reach this celebrity status. And I feel like this is a very millennial kind of influencer take, because we grew up with the birth of an influencer. And I feel like Gen Z don't really have the same take. And I feel like this is how people become successful, because let's say very simply, because millennials grew up with YouTube, mainly watch YouTube. And as I said, the timeline is you follow a YouTuber for 5 to 10 years before they're successful, and they've built up this whole kind of audience, and then they're successful and the numbers are kind of like staggering for what they've had to do in order to engage this audience and keep this audience and grow this audience, compared to TikTok, where everything happens very, very quick. With Gen Z, let's presume they all use TikTok mainly. You can go viral overnight and become famous for one video, which isn't always monetizable as well. So just because you go viral with one video on TikTok, it doesn't mean you're financially successful or wealthy. So I feel like that younger generation doesn't necessarily link being a modern day influencer to extreme wealth. Does that make sense, or am I chatting shit? Let me know. I rambled on a bit then, sorry. Speaking of influencers faking flights and going on holidays, one influencer, Natalia Taylor, who has over 2 million subscribers on YouTube and 300,000 followers on Instagram, posted these beautiful shots of her on holiday in Bali. Look at them. Announcing the queen has arrived in Bali. The only thing was, this wasn't Bali, this was Ikea. This fake luxury vacation cost her absolutely nothing, but got her a ton of attention, views, clicks, likes, profile visits, followers, and media attention that some brands would pay hundreds of thousands for. That kind of free advertising. But this isn't a classic case of an influencer trying to trick their followers into believing they're successful or rich, or believing their fake life. This was actually an experiment to show just how easy it is to trick people into believing what they see online. Around time, influencers were actually faking their luxury holidays. She actually asked her photographer to leave in some labels. They did edit out the majority of them, but she left in these kind of like little clues that this was just a showroom in IKEA, and nobody spotted them. And And this kind of turned into a YouTube challenge in the end, with people faking kind of like these holidays, faking their luxury hauls, pretending to be rich, all that kind of stuff. But this was based on actual Instagrammers, travel vloggers, all those kind of creators who were actually faking these kind of holidays, or where they were on holidays, or their exact locations, their views, where they were staying. And one of the most notable is a lady called Amelia Liana, who faked a penthouse suite style view. You've probably all seen this picture if you're into Instagram versus reality. She's in her penthouse. This is an expensive view in New York. You can tell this is like somewhere expensive because the view is looking all over New York. But one of the most notable things other than the view in this picture is her reflection. It's not mirrored. It's from behind her. So it's kind of like the window in front of her is reflecting her back. Strange thing to do. But also the Freedom Tower is missing in this picture. She missed a whole building from this view. So people instantly clocked that she was actually photoshopping her locations and, you know, what she was actually doing on holiday. There's this picture of the Taj Mahal with a weird reflection in the water, really poorly photoshopped, kind of squished in for some reason, and completely empty. This is a tourist attraction amongst many other amazing things, but people flock to see this amazing building, yet it's completely empty, and there's something just off. There's something very off about this picture. It's poorly photoshopped, like these air balloons in this picture here. She was just photoshopping these incredible views, but there's something so uncanny about them, something strange about them, something off as far as like the size of certain things go. And it's weird because so what? She's on holiday and she photoshopped a few things, but if she's like a travel influencer, isn't it weird to fake your views, fake where you're going if you're influencing people to travel to these locations? Is that a thing? Is false advertising locations a thing? Like, would you be annoyed if you got this penthouse suite and then you saw the Freedom Tower? No, that doesn't make sense. Whilst it's not like illegal, I just think it's a weird thing to do. The view from that building would have been amazing anyway. The view of the Taj Mahal, sure, you have people in the picture, would have been incredible anyway because it's an incredible location. You don't need to fake it and kind of like, I don't know, change the sky blue and put a weird reflection in the pool. I don't know. To me, it's odd. Let's get back to the business of fake luxury, the industry of fake luxury. Touching on what I said earlier, according to a report that Vice reported on in 2020, they found that having roughly 42,000 followers is enough to earn you an average UK salary in ad revenue and sponsored posts. In 2020, that was around 38,000. With that in mind, sometimes you see people on 10,000, which you can still make a really good living off, pretending to have millions and millions because of the fact that they are an influencer. Maybe, yes, they were rich, they have come from a rich family, whatever, but it does take time to build up your audience and earn a huge amount of money on YouTube. And as I said, the more money you have, the more successful you appear to be. More people would want to subscribe to you, and the more brand deals you could potentially get. And China seems to be a bit of an influencer hub, almost like a training ground for influencers. I don't know if you've seen that content creation farm, a post from China, where it's just what looks like hundreds of influencers filming on their phones in like this, almost like, they look like chickens in like a battery chicken farm. It's crazy. But China has one of the largest fake wealth industries in the world. There is a company for who as little as 90 cents, I don't know, like 60 pence, will put your voice over a video of someone fanning out money, walking up to your luxury car, in private planes, luxury locations, so it looks as though you are there in person. You are the person experiencing these luxuries. A first person shot of your luxury life. They'll even fake receipts of luxury purchases, clothing receipts, and the idea is that these kind of like purchases, these kind of videos are meant to be aspirational, get people to follow you. And luxury brands may take notice and actually send you these items for free, or send you on luxury holidays, or loan you a luxury car for the day in real life. A trend that overtook social media in China was the flaunt your wealth trend, and it did actually make its way over to like Instagram and TikTok. And this trend showed the influencer who appeared to have fallen over, stumbled down some stairs, or fallen out of their luxury car, and the contents of their purse or bag pockets was laid out all over the floor. And of course, these would be luxury items. These would be your designer handbag, all your designer makeup, money, just wealth scattered all over you. However, this trend actually faced a lot of backlash in China, and a sort of anti-wealth campaign took place, with the Chinese version of TikTok Douyin being fined the equivalent of $31,000 for the promotion of promoting excessive wealth. And what people refer to as a Chinese version of Instagram, Xiaohongshu, changing their algorithm to identify wealth flaunting, kind of trying to push that back down into the algorithm. So while it's not fake wealth, I feel like it just kind of goes to show you how popular looking at other people's wealth can actually be, but also how much of a problem it can potentially be. Bearing in mind, I don't know a lot about Chinese law and government, and I'm sure there's something to be said about censorship there, but I feel like that's for somebody else to talk about, not me. Something I've been fully aware of that I completely forgot about, and something Vice actually reported on again, was the huge industry of selling empty designer bags and empty designer boxes. Empty bags and boxes of designer goods are kind of popping up on Depop of all places. And influencers are buying these empty bags to pose with, display in the backgrounds of videos, and anywhere where it will look like they got themselves something nice, you know? But it's not actually just that. It's not themselves like by themselves like a little wallet or purse. It's them buying excessive amounts of designer goods. Well, empty bags. There's one very popular Depop shop that has over 600 empty designer bags and boxes. They sell everything from like, it's like £20 for an Hermes ribbon. And then like £5 for a empty Louis Vuitton bag with a receipt inside. As like proof of purchase, you just don't have the item. But according to Scott Guthrie, who is an influencer marketing consultant, he says that this fake wealth is very, very easy to spot. And I do agree with him. He says you can usually spot it. Usually something is a little off in the image, he says. The accessory doesn't quite match the outfit, or there may be too many ostentatious signals of wealth in view. And I agree. I mean, you can look at someone carrying all these empty Louis Vuitton bags, or like they've just been to Harrods Hall, but they're wearing something you know you got from ASOS for £5. And that's not to say that you can't mix kind of like high street with designer or online with designer, but if you've never actually seen them wear these designer goods or flaunt them, yet they constantly got these empty bags, something's up, you know? Because if you're a fashion influencer, you'll want to show the designer items you got. He continues to say that not only is flaunting fake wealth very obvious, it can also hurt the identities of certain luxury brands. Creators masquerade as brand ambassadors may tarnish that particular brand rather than promote it. I guess the idea is that these fashion influencers want to eventually actually work with these brands or be able to afford these brands. But if you're doing something like this, brands do take note. And they will not work with you if you've been pretending to work with them. And there are influencers who very early on in their career will pretend to have a sponsored job with a certain brand for some reason. I'm not sure many people do it anymore, but people were being called out for it about 4 years ago. Speaking of luxury purchases, TikToker Midi For Real recently exposed a popular group of rich and pretty influencers from China who are known for their luxury items and their luxury getaways and, you know, exposing their extreme wealth on Instagram. In her video, she explains that a guy went undercover in their WhatsApp group. He somehow infiltrated their WhatsApp group, pretending to be another luxury influencer. And he kind of went into this group chat thinking, you know, I'm going to find out, you know, all the luxury locations they're sharing, where they're going to be staying, what they're spending their money on. But he actually found something very, very different. This group chat was actually dedicated to them sharing ideas of how are they going to appear rich and wealthy? How are they going to pretend they live a certain lifestyle and basically get jobs off of it and get freebies? This WhatsApp group was filled with 60 plus influencers. And what they do is they would, for example, rent a Ferrari for a day, which split between 60 people isn't that much. It's not that expensive. They'd rent designer bags, they'd rent designer outfits, they'd rent hotel rooms just for one night and just for one day, and kind of had dedicated time slots. Splitting the cost of something amongst friends isn't a big deal. Like, we all do it, right? Like hotels, you know, like we'll all try and stay like four people to a two bedroom. We've all been there, we've all done it, we all still do it sometimes. But there's something about pretending that it's your lifestyle and trying to like gain from that and mislead people that kind of it's kind of weird. The more I look at this, the more I think it's less about faking wealth, the majority of the time. And I think it's about getting free stuff. I think it's about, oh, if I look like I'm being sent abroad, or if I look I'm being gifted this stay, or if I look like I can document well my luxury stays, my luxury holidays, then maybe brands will actually notice this, send me stuff, send me to places for free, and I will look like a successful influencer. And I also don't think it's a good tactic for influencers to flash wealth. I just don't think it is. There are many, many influencers who flashing their wealth and showing off has been their downfall. The audience who initially subscribed to them because they were relatable, or they kind of thought they were on the same level of reality, who then become very, very wealthy and flash it and flaunt it. You know, people see them as being out of touch. I think Rice Gum is a very good example of this. People loved him because he was relatable, real. And then the more successful he got, the more kind of like just weird and kind of like rude and horrible and nasty and flashing his wealth that he became, people were turned off by this. I love a good luxury unboxing video. I love looking around rich houses, you know, estate agent videos, because sometimes luxury getaways are nice to watch, you know? And yeah, sometimes I do spoil myself as well. And I do think there's a difference between showing what you have, because it's what the theme of your whole channel is, to then flaunting and showing off. I think there's almost a fine line, but there's a big difference, especially in times of financial uncertainty for not just a lot of people, but for a lot of countries as well. Although there's been no official announcements, I feel like a lot of people are going into recession right now. And I also don't think being super rich is aspirational for many people anymore. I just don't think it is. Because I feel like just getting by is people's main priority nowadays. Of course, for a lot of people, having a lot of money would be a lot nicer, you know? It'll be make an easier life for a lot of people. But I don't think people find that kind of content aspirational. And what do you mean? I don't think it gives them a drive to get up and go. I don't think it gives them a drive to be like, that's who I want to be. That's what I want my life to be. Let's go out there and do it. As I said, when really at the moment, people just want to be able to afford everyday necessities. And even if people are in a position to buy stuff nowadays, most people want it on a budget at the moment. So there's a look into this fake wealth industry that's going on that I was kind of aware of, but there's so much more to it. I can do a second part to this video, especially with the influencers who kind of Photoshop themselves into this situation. Let me know what you think about this down below. This is a conversation. Check out that community post for a load of comments and replies. There was so many. I kind of like struggled to pick out even just a couple because so many people were making so many good points. But let me know your thoughts on this down below. You can watch the whole Instagram versus reality playlist here, some general lighter entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.